Thanks to Morning Brew for sponsoring today's video. The James Webb Space Telescope. Named after the NASA administrator who oversaw the Apollo moon landings, this space behemoth is the largest, most powerful, and most complex space telescope ever built. It has been hailed as the successor of Hubble, which itself was instrumental in expanding our understanding of the universe over the last few decades. It has undergone major redesigns, cost $9.7 billion to build, and has taken 25 years to fully develop, construct, and test. There were moments in its decades-long construction where it was very nearly cancelled completely. And yet, with the aid of scientists from several nations around the world, it has overcome hurdle after hurdle. But for all this, it will only last in space for a maximum of 10 years. Why have scientists undertaken the construction of this telescope? Why put all this time, money, and effort into building something that will be, relatively speaking, so short-lived? The answer is because this telescope, in a way unlike any before it, will allow us to peer through time to the beginnings of the universe itself. I'm Alex McColgan, and you're watching Astrum. Join with me today as we explore how this incredible spacecraft will allow scientists to pull back the curtain on the first galaxies to come into existence after the Big Bang. Together we will discover the science and engineering that went into it, as well as the challenges it faced. Because this truly will be a spacecraft that will help us access clues to the universe's origins like no other. The James Webb Space Telescope first began in 1996. NASA at that time had for years been considering a Next Generation Space Telescope, or NGST, to help them find the data they desired, and the original plan was to make an 8-meter aperture telescope that would cost approximately $500 million. However, as time went on, decision makers realized that far more resources would be needed to achieve their aims. But what exactly were their aims? Well, the NGST was to be an infrared telescope. Hubble had been functioning since 1990, but its primary range was the visible light and ultraviolet light spectrums. Although it had some infrared detection capability, this was somewhat limited. And why do scientists want a powerful infrared telescope? Well, this comes down to some fundamental facts about the universe itself. Scientists believe the universe as we know it has existed for roughly 13.8 billion years. How it all began is a fascinating question, and one that many have theorized over. Current mainstream theories revolve around the idea of a Big Bang, where all matter existed in a space so small it was effectively zero. Atoms did not even exist at that stage, they would have been too large. Suddenly, everything expanded outwards at once. Matter began to coalesce into atoms, and then dust, then stars, and planets, and the universe has expanded and cooled ever since. But wouldn't it be helpful to be able to look back and see for ourselves those first moments of creation, or the formation of those first galaxies? That might give us insights into exactly how all of it happened. The James Webb Space Telescope will either provide evidence for the Big Bang, or completely change our theories, thanks to the way light travels. To a point at least. While light is blindingly fast, it's not instantaneous. There is a tiny time delay between when light is emitted and when we see it. Photons, or particles of light, travel at a constant rate, 299,792,458 meters per second exactly. Our sun sits at a point 148 million kilometers from us. This means that it takes approximately 500 seconds for light to travel from it to us. So, what you see in the sky right now is not the sun as it is, but the sun as it was 8 minutes and 20 seconds ago. This time delay becomes severe even when you consider things that are relatively close to us. The next nearest star, Proxima Centauri, is so distant from Earth that it takes 4 years for its light to reach us. All of this means that, for objects that are further and further away from us, we would see it as it was further and further back in time. If there was an object sufficiently far away, we would see it as it was 13.8 billion years ago, near the origin of the universe. And fortunately, as some speculate, we exist in an infinite universe, so such faraway objects should in fact exist. With the James Webb Space Telescope, we hope to be able to see them. But why does the James Webb Space Telescope view in the infrared? Well, one reason is that infrared light tends to punch through clouds of cosmic matter better, allowing us to see past otherwise opaque gas clouds, to see what lies on the other side. But the main reason, and the one that is relevant to seeing those early galaxies, is because of a second quirk of the universe, the fact that space is expanding. For reasons we don't fully understand, but which scientists currently theorize are the result of dark energy, everything in the universe is moving away from everything else constantly. As a star moves away from us, the light from it is stretched in a process known as the Doppler effect. And because the wavelength of light is the part that defines what color we see, as light stretches, it shifts further and further towards the red half of the spectrum. But this expansion isn't constant. Scientists have observed that the further something is away from us, the faster it is expanding away from us too. This means that light from the furthest away galaxies have shifted so far into the red that it has gone beyond it, into infrared frequencies. Hubble was not fully designed to detect these frequencies, the James Webb Space Telescope is. James Webb's receptors can detect light at frequencies from 0.6 micrometers to 28.5 micrometers long. Interestingly, this means that it actually can't see all visible light frequencies. It can see red and a large amount of orange frequencies, but nothing beyond yellow. Its focus lies in the infrared frequencies. In this way, to say that the James Webb Space Telescope is a replacement for Hubble is factually incorrect. At NASA, they prefer to say that James Webb supports and complements Hubble. Each will focus on frequencies of light that the other does not see so clearly. Besides which, as Hubble could potentially last until 2040, it's likely that it will outlast the James Webb Space Telescope too, which would make James Webb an odd replacement. Still, to see these infrared rays from such distant sources is a huge challenge. If you and a friend each held a candle on a clear night and walked away from each other, it wouldn't be too long before your candle started to look dimmer to the other person. This is because of the inverse square law, where light photons spread out with distance. Plus, light tends to scatter when it passes through matter. And although space is extremely empty, there's enough particles of dust floating around that over the vast distances of space, objects that are far away get more difficult to see. To combat this, the James Webb Space Telescope houses a gold-plated beryllium mirror that is 6.5 meters in diameter. This makes its surface area 6 times larger than that of Hubble's mirror. This larger mirror is designed to catch more light from distant sources before focusing it back into the telescope's instruments, allowing them to pick up fainter traces of radiation. Furthermore, as the name suggests, the James Webb Space Telescope is a space mirror. Being in space means that the telescope does not have to contend with the Earth's atmosphere, which can diffract and distort light waves that pass through it. The vacuum of space provides a much clearer view, allowing James Webb to find those tiny diffuse infrared waves much more easily. James Webb will be orbiting the Earth in a position known as the L2 Lagrange point. This position in space is technically not a true orbit, but exists 1.5 million kilometers from the Earth at the point furthest away from the Sun. For point of reference, the Moon is 384,400 kilometers from the Earth, so this is much further out. Due to the way the Earth's gravity interacts with the Sun's, this point of space is gravitationally stable, making it easier for an object to hover there with minimal effort. This makes it an ideal viewing station for an orbital telescope. One spacecraft was sent there already, the Planck Space Observatory. The distance from Earth is far enough away that the James Webb Space Telescope does not have to contend with any radiation bouncing off the Earth or the Moon. But it is also close enough that it can send signals back to Earth telling us what it sees. Naturally, at this position, it will be very difficult for us to visit the James Webb Space Telescope. So, although James Webb was designed with a docking ring, it is currently planned that there will be no missions to James Webb to service or replace its parts once it's up there. Although it needs minimal effort to maintain its position, minimal is not zero. James Webb has enough fuel to maintain its position for at least 5 years, and at most 10. After that, it will decay from its orbit and will no longer function. It has a guaranteed expiration date. One final benefit of this position, however, is the temperature. Because heat travels in infrared waves, the heat generated by the telescope's own parts could potentially blind its own sensors if left unchecked. However, thanks to its position in space, James Webb will be able to cool itself to temperatures of minus 223 degrees Celsius. This is also aided by its solar shield. You have no doubt noticed the large silver canvas at the bottom of the satellite. This five-layered shield is the size of a tennis court and is designed to point in the direction of the Sun, Earth, and Moon to block heat coming from them. With that last fact, you may have begun to realize the scale of this satellite. It is vast, roughly 20 meters by 14 meters, and weighing almost 6,500 kilograms. This raises a question: how are they going to get this telescope into orbit? Well, that is explained by one of the most, frankly, astounding engineering aspects of this telescope: its capacity to fold up and unfold. The Ariane 5 rocket that will carry James Webb into orbit has a 5-meter diameter, but this is not sufficient to fit the James Webb Space Telescope. As such, James Webb has been designed so that its mirror can fold in, as can its solar shield, reducing its total dimensions while it is in the rocket. Once it has been launched, and while it is traversing space to its Lagrange point, the James Webb Space Telescope will begin gradually unfurling in a delicate ballet. Arms will unfurl, shields will unspool, the hexagons of the mirror will rotate into position, and then align themselves with the aid of tiny motors that are perfectly flush with each other, all to allow it to go about its incredibly delicate business of gathering radiation from the dimmest lights in the sky. Mastering this process of getting such a sensitive device into orbit without something breaking is the reason James Webb has taken so long to build. Remember, once launched, there is no chance of going up there and fixing it. If something broke during deployment, it could well spell the end of the entire mission, wasting over 2 decades of work and $9.7 billion. In 2005, just a few years before the initial intended launch date, the entire project underwent a fundamental redesign. Everything was checked and double-checked by review boards. In 2018, the project was further delayed when a test of deploying the solar shield ended up with it ripping. A review of what went wrong found an additional 344 potential single-point failures, any one of which breaking would mean that the entire thing would no longer work. When costs started rising in 2011, the American Congress moved to reduce NASA's budget as a way of cancelling James Webb. However, the public backlash in support of the project ultimately led them to reverse their decision. James Webb was built by NASA in cooperation with the European Space Agency and the Canadian Space Agency. It has been delayed over 13 times. Its project costs have increased from $500 million to $9.7 billion. But finally, very soon, it will be here. Its mission to peer into the heart of space and uncover the mysteries of the formation of the first galaxies, stars, and planets will finally begin. You can bet that when it launches from the European spaceport in French Guiana, there will be plenty of people waiting for news of a successful launch with bated breath. And you can also bet that once it's in the sky, scientists will be fighting tooth and nail to get a chance to look through it and to discover what wonders it sees. So, good luck for the launch and the deployment to all the teams involved with this. If it works, this instrument will be the biggest thing for space science for potentially decades to come. Now, James Webb should launch this year, but you might want to keep checking the news for the latest updates. One way I keep up to date with the goings-on in the world is this pretty handy resource called Morning Brew, which is a completely free email newsletter that's sent to your inbox 7 days a week. It covers all things business, finance, and tech, and also covers space if there's anything exciting going on. With today's Morning Brew, I found out that the Japanese billionaire has now made it to the ISS on the first tourist trip there for a decade. It's great to browse, as the newsletter is concise, yet still has an element of charm to it. It's not super dry like typical news summaries. If there is something you want to know more about in depth, There's links throughout that take you to full articles on news websites. It takes less than 15 seconds to subscribe, so why not give it a go? If this is something you would like to check out further, find the link in the description below. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, check out my other telescope video I made on ESO's upcoming Extremely Large Telescope, which is a really exciting project. Thanks to my patrons and members for their support. If you want to support too, check the links in the description. All the best and see you next time.